The phone call's just come in.
Oh, who is it?
Is it Wiggly Scott? Oh,
hi, I'm Wiggly Scott. This is a second video tour I'm doing of a settlement that isn't mine. In fact, it's not even me that's doing the tour. So I'm going to pass you over to John Paul. This is his gamer tag. Take it away.
Okay, so here we are at Echo Lake, and this is probably the best weather I think I have ever seen on the island. Anyway, so Echo Lake, as you come around here, this is my defense turrets. Now, I don't know if you know this area. Have you done anything here yourself yet, Scott?
No, I've visited here and looked around, but I'm looking forward to seeing this because it's one of the only settlements I didn't have a chance to build in before my game became too broken.
Well, there is a bit of a glitch here, and this is one of the fun things. So this is where, when your settlement gets attacked, pretty much everything spawns. And this turret, these set of turrets are enough to deal with anything. I've had several Deathclaws spawn here, and they've just killed them in seconds. But the problem is, no matter where you put the spawn mat, the fast travel mat, it completely ignores it.
Okay. It does that in Boston Airport as well.
Does it? I haven't tried it there. But this is one of those. So you'll always start here, surrounded by whatever enemies are attacking that thing. And with about, I don't know, 3/4 of a second to try and run away before they die. And I've just noticed that because I've never seen the billboards here before, actually, because the weather's usually so terrible, you never actually see them.
It's just a grey blob, isn't it?
Yeah, just a blob. Here we are, on the way into Echo Lake. So we come in through the gateway. Shut that behind us.
Ah, dog, mate.
Goodbye, mate. And I think the first building we'll have a look at is my clinic. Now, this building here, you'll find out when you go there yourself, is actually sealed up. You can't get in it. But scrap that settlement allowed me to delete.
Delete! Delete! Delete!
The doorway.
The magic of mods.
The magic of mods, indeed. So I originally thought there'd just be, you know, a little doorway in, and you still wouldn't be able to do anything with the building, and I was going to do something else with it. But to my surprise, got rid of the board covering the doorway, and you can get in. So this is now my clinic. Now, the settlement build area does cut across this room around about here, which is presumably there why they've blocked it off. But you can still happily build in the rest of it. So here we have
Egghead!
Yes, my surgery bot, complete with drill and axe.
He looks like a banana in a metal suit.
Yes, banana man. Do you remember him?
Yeah.
And this is where the clinic is supposed to be. As usual, he's decided not to be here today. He's off doing something else. Counter and his bed, and there's a little sort of gurney there for his patients, and the x-rays of whoever it is he's been working on recently, and I don't know what the hell he's been doing here, but there we go.
Trying to make medicines from Deathclaws? Maybe there's a particular gene that a Deathclaw has he could make medicine from.
Genetic manipulation. Well, that was, of course, where they came from in the first place, so maybe we should leave them alone, yeah. I think. Here we go. This is my weapon shop. And she's actually at her till today, so that's good. My little weapons caravan, movable. So she should be able to move if she wants to. And here we go. So here we go, as you come into the building, of course you've got the heavy weapons on their racks here and a few example guns on the side. And there's our shopkeep.
Is that lantern swinging? Behind us. Behind you now, there's a lantern.
Oh, this one. Yeah, yeah. It's swinging. Swinging lanterns. Swinging in the breeze. Yeah, quite a nice touch, that, I think.
An animation.
Yep. I think that comes from the G2M mod, if I remember correctly. It's got a sort of nautical area, and that's one of the bits and pieces in it. It's quite a good mod, I think. But yep, there you go. Counter with a bucket of bins. Little pirate flag. And in here you have the melee weapons. Can't see so clearly through the glass. Nope. Oh well, nonetheless. And as you come out here and up here, this is where she lives. So it's her own little sort of portable live and work area. So here we have her bed with a little love note from personally my favourite psychopath, Pikmin.
It's not my favourite psychopath. My favourite psychopath is Sid Justice from the WWF in the 80s.
Oh, and here's her little balcony. So she's got a couch out there and a little coffee table with some beers. Does her cooking. And her ironing, of course. Although, to look at her, I'm not sure what exactly it is she's ironing. Probably the tyres.
The ropes around her legs.
Yeah.
It's built on a trailer, isn't it?
It is, it is. So, if she can find herself a working vehicle, she can hitch it up and take it on to whatever other settlement she wants to go to.
We're going to Disneyland, baby!
I left the logs and things here, because I don't know about you, I just kind of like them. Adds a bit of flavour.
Yeah.
And also we'll take the main building next, and when you come here you'll see, sort of from this, but you'll certainly see for yourself, it's a mess. The whole thing is just a wreck. I've done my best to patch it up. But there we go.
Hey.
So, as we come in, first thing we have, get out of the way, dog meat.
Now that's some fire.
Is our general goods seller. With a bit of junk and stuff behind her tills. And they're not here at the moment, but sometimes, if we're very lucky, we get one of the traders from Bunker Hill standing there. Anyway, yep, this is a junk shop. All the junk she's selling, including magical cans, for some reason.
Yeah, I love those magical cans.
And this is her little bedroom area, which she can't learn to shut the gate with. But there we go. So in here she's got her safe where she keeps all her loot. And there's where she has her lunch.
And slippers. I saw
and slippers.
Slippers. I found them slippers the other day. I had to use them slippers. As soon as I saw it. And I put them near the dressing gown as well. Near the bathrobe.
And here we go. You can see what the floor was like in here a little bit. Well, and the walls. And the ceilings. But anyway, the whole place is a mess. This is the bar slash, restaurant area. And the barman's actually behind the bar today. He likes to stand out here at the front for some reason. I don't know why.
He's making sure he can welcome you that little bit sooner.
And here we have our little robot helper, Soda.
Floaty-like.
Who likes to sell or hand out at least the special drugged soda to all the settlers that make them nice and happy, so very, very happy.
And want to spend caps.
Now, so up here, this is mostly just some living areas, nothing very special, but have had more walls and
you think this piece
holes in the floor to fix.
How did you get those floorboards so deep in the floor?
These ones?
Yeah.
Well, a lot of fiddling about, really, just to get one in, and then the others sort of snap to it, but I think these are, if I remember correctly, the warehouse floor pieces.
The vanilla warehouse pieces.
Yeah. They're quite forgiving for snapping.
Yeah.
As you can see, I've actually used the wall pieces as well. These are actually barn pieces, but
behind
same
you,
thing.
Is that... Those desks were already there, weren't they, by the looks of them?
They were, yes.
Yeah.
Yeah. I think I placed the computer and the chair.
I like to try
to replace the broken computer that was there.
Yeah, I like to try and keep some of the features of the house.
Yeah, I'll clear up some of the clutter when I need to, but It's always nice to keep some pieces.
And this, did you put that in? Kitchen.
No, that was already there. But it was full of rubbish. And it's just been tidied up in a few.
I've just now, John Paul, got a mod that allows me to put those kitchen cabinets up. I did have the mod before, but it wouldn't place anywhere. It wouldn't land, no matter where you put it. It wouldn't
do anything. Yeah.
But I've just got one that actually works.
Well, some of these mods, I think, have been ported over from PC, and I'm led to believe that you can just place them down anywhere without having to place them first like we have to. But up here, mostly just wall repairs, roof repairs. And this is where the barkeep has his little bedroom.
And that, so if he's laying in bed playing with his balls, can't people see him through the floor playing with his balls?
Well, I suppose they could do, but that is... So back out we go. I did want to do a lot more on this settlement, to be honest with you, but it was getting a little bit crashy.
Very, very, very crashy, crashy, crashy! Yeah.
So I've had to stop. Before I was quite finished, I intended to put more sort of bedrooms and things down here, but this is all more or less vanilla, just tidied, walls fixed. Because, yeah, if I built very much more, I think it would just crash all the time.
Yeah. Oops.
We'll go out this door because it's
close to where we want to be.
Yes. Again, thank you, dog meat. So here we have the power station. And I'm quite happy with the way this turned out, actually. I think the mix of vault pieces with the concrete worked quite well.
Yeah, I'm surprised you managed to get that door in there.
Yeah, it took a bit of fiddling. I think if I remember correctly, I had to basically build a section of with vault pieces, then remove it and replace them.
Yeah.
Leaving the door there. Down you go. So this is also the workstation area. So you've got all the workplace pieces. Power armor bits and
even some health and safety pictures.
Yeah, indeed.
Wear your hat.
Some more vault pieces in the corner there.
Yeah, I like those vault pieces in the corner. They look good with the concrete.
Yeah. Unfortunately, I couldn't get them to go on at the top here because they seem to want to stick right out the top of the building. But hey ho. And this is where the power station control room is.
It's a nice ceiling.
Yeah, it is, isn't it? There's a little red ceiling there. All the computers to control the...
What's the sign say up there?
Reactor.
Reactor, yeah.
There's a control reactor. Also allows you to control the population, actually. But still. If you want to get actually up to the top, I'm afraid we have to leave. Oh, we're short in for a red storm.
Lovely.
How nice. It is, isn't it? There we go. Couldn't last forever. If it gets worse, we might have to call the Minutemen weather people and see if they can't fix this for us.
Put a call in. Put a call in.
Put a call in. We'll do that in a second. So, right, let's do that now, shall we?
Okay.
And there we go. Never let it be said that the Minutemen aren't efficient. Look at that. So up we come. And here we have the generators. And when I feel like I need it, the recruitment beacon. Oh yes, so this little barn here, again I've kept the wood, just think it adds a bit of flavour, but tried my best to fix the walls, add some doors, and in this area over here, this is where the machinery was originally for the logs to go down into the water, so I've patched that up again a bit, and it's now become my robot.
You left the pallet on the area. Floor, or did you put that down?
No, I put that down.
Oh, did you?
Yeah, yeah. Well, robot pieces were previously on it, rather I just haven't gotten rid of it after I've done. So there's nothing much out here. Just a small bit of tidying up and fixing some lights so they actually work now. And this is the guard post. So you know me, I usually like to basically turn my settlements into forts. And they'd usually be walled. They'd have a perimeter wall.
Yeah.
And but again, running out of build limit.
That's the thing, I find you run out of so much build limit. Right, instead of building a wall all the way around the settlement, I'd rather just have a lot of guns, and so that anything that comes even anywhere near your settlement gets blown to pieces, and then you don't have to have such a great big wall eating up all your build space, you know?
I know.
But yes, I understand.
It's just a psychological thing for me. If I was doing this in real life, I would build a perimeter wall and have loads of big guns.
Yeah.
Or as many and as big as I could find. So up here you do get, again, a reasonably nice view. There are some nice views in Fallout.
I like those fence posts. Where do you get them fence posts?
Well, actually, they are attached to the walkway thing here.
Oh, okay.
So I'm not sure if you can find them separately on their own somewhere as well, but these ones were attached. And this is the guard here, armed with a sniper rifle normally, but he's not showing it to us at the moment. Around here we have his offices and bedroom.
Excellent.
Oh, and of course the
plenty
the
of
water purifiers.
Yeah.
Funding the Minutemen.
Mm. The water racket.
Yeah. Well, it's either that or jet, isn't it?
Mm. All the way back down the stairs. Where are we going next?
Okay, so I think actually the next thing we're going to see, and nice blue skies again.
Mm.
How about that? Here we have the fishing area, where most of the food for the settlement is provided. Of course, we've got our little fishermen here feeding the little fishies.
And you've got the wood in the water.
Yep.
Nice
and low, and a turret just in case anyone should try, you know, swimming across.
Yeah.
But anyway, here we go. Here's the arena, as you can see. The sign says it all. And we come along here. It's not actually set up for any fights at the moment, so unless we've got time at the end of this. Oh well, poor Red Rocket. As we get time at the end of this, we can set up a fight, but probably won't at this rate. Managed to get rid of a lot of the junk and broken benches here, and even replace it with some nice, fresh benches, so the settlers will actually sit here and use it when there's a fight on. And there's the arena there, and the little treasure chest that they can win at the end of the fight. So, of course, the combatants stand here on these plates.
Which you've sunk into the ground, I see.
Yes, yeah.
I didn't know you could didn't think of doing that. That's good.
It just makes it a little bit easier to get people in here.
Yeah.
You know? And then up here, you have my throne, from which I control the fight.
The sickening violence.
And, well, the weather couldn't have stayed nice forever, could it? So, here we go with more typical weather for this area. Oh, look. The power station was quite nice. Anyway, so yes, here's my throne.
Bring the rain!
From here, I control all the fights in the arena. I really wanted the sort of Mad Maxi / Thunderdome type throne here. Based a bit upon the Throne of Swords in Game of Thrones. the only person who's ever not seen it at this stage.
Yeah.
Anyway, so here we go. Sitting in my throne. Here. Control. Nice. There we go.
Awesome.
And were there anyone there? Maybe in doing that.
Whooping some ass.
Anyway, so I think that's it, really.
Is that your tour?
That's my tour finished now.
Of
Echo Lake Lumberyard.
So, like, subscribe. Thanks for watching. See you next time.
Goodbye.